Hey everyone, my name's Asia and today I'm going to be teaching you guys how to do a cartwheel.
I sound like a baby. I'm not, I promise. I'm sorry. Here's the intro. If we bump into each other on a crowded street, it's not us no more. It's just you and me. We're just strangers in passing.
It's just you and me, oh yeah. You guys how to do a cartwheel. That's probably the reason why I clicked on this video. And if maybe you know how to do a cartwheel and you're just trying to get a little bit better at it, then this may be the video for you. If you're just struggling or if you just haven't got it yet for any age, then this is a good way to learn. I taught myself how to do all of this stuff. I've never been to gymnastics. I've never done like cheer or tumbling or anything. So I teach myself how to do this stuff. And my friend Riley, she's self-taught and she knows how to do all this stuff on her own. And she teaches me sometimes and it helps me a lot. And it also helps Macy too, which is also on this account, which you will be seeing a video from them very soon. So I'm gonna show you guys the way that I learned how to do it. I'm not gonna guarantee you that this is gonna help you, but I'm just saying that maybe this will give you a good basis on what to do, or maybe this may actually help you learn how to do a cartwheel, or maybe help you critique your cartwheel or whatever you're trying to do. So let's get on with the video.
Also, I'm going to be going on to a voiceover, and make sure to follow my YouTube account called Weirdly Simple, and make sure to follow Riley's YouTube account called Simply Riley. And Macy doesn't have a YouTube account. Maybe she'll start one up soon. But we have some really cool videos on there too, so if you guys want to go see that, then you should go see that as well. Then you can see more of an inside life other than gymnastics and cheer and all that other stuff. Hey everybody, welcome to voiceover number one. So first, I guess what we're going to do is we're going to dance, because you always dance before you do a cartwheel. And then we're going to fall on my bed. And then, I don't know what I'm going to... Oh, we're going to jump on my bed now. And then we're going to fall and break something. So now... it's time to hit the gym. Every time you do any sort of physical thing, you need to stretch. So please stretch. Even if it's a cartwheel, even if it's a handstand, stretch. So now I'm going to, I guess, roll out my ankles. No, that's not rolling out my ankles. Forget I said that. We're gonna roll out my ankles now. So that's one leg. And let's just take a second to listen to this other foot crack. Okay, glad my foot's okay. But anyways, when starting off a cartwheel, you need to have a good stance. You can't just be standing any kind of way. It's very not helpful. Also, when you do a cartwheel, make sure to stand straight. I know most people try to turn to the side, but it doesn't help. Also, lift up your arms and your legs first and take a quick lift off. Just lifting up your other leg, this can help you with momentum if you're not very strong. So here's just a slow-mo version of it, just so you guys can hear, you know, see what's going on right now. It's literally just giving yourself a little bit of momentum. Momentum is just a push off, I guess. So now that we got that down, you guys can pause the video and take any time you need. So now what you're going to do is you're going to go and go down to the side like that. So that's why I told you guys to stand forward. To do a proper cartwheel, you need to stand forward, and you're supposed to turn your body slightly to the side. So just slightly turn your body to the side, and here you go, just a quick little slow-mo so you guys can see what I'm doing. If you guys need help, make sure to pause the video if you guys need some time to figure that out. All right, so now that we got that down, let's go on to step two. Okay, so next step, when you are going into doing cartwheel, make sure to have your stance. Make sure to do the first part, giving yourself momentum and going down, and then give yourself a little bit of a push. Now, this is very important. If you don't give yourself a push, there is no cartwheel. This is what's basically forcing your body over, and this is helping you get the cartwheel down. This is also why you need to stretch, because you can hurt yourself doing this. Not from hitting anything with your feet, but from your body not being able to twist. For the next part, which I'm going to show you guys right now. Alright, ladies and gents, this is the last two parts of to doing a cartwheel is really easy. So basically you just go over and you're going to push yourself up into a handstand position. Now, if you don't know how to do a handstand, then just push off, but don't give yourself too much momentum because then you'll flip over. And that will rush your cartwheel, or you can even fall and do a freaking walkover. So just go down like we did, momentum, and go into a handstand. That was a really good one, Asia. Good job on that one. My legs aren't straight, I'm sorry, but this is a really quick tutorial that I'm just trying to get really quickly. All right, next part. So when you go over, you just go over. Like, once you're up in the air, you want to force your legs over the other direction from where you came from. Now, that will help you so you can land the cartwheel the other direction. I mean, it's really easy. And if you guys want to learn how to do a round off, please make sure to ask me because this will help you. So watch this slow-mo. It's just giving you a quick, like, it's just going over. It's really hard to explain at the end, but you guys will get it once you guys start doing it yourself. Just thrust your legs over and it will help. So now I want you guys to watch my hands. Watch my hands. This is going to help you a lot. So you're just going to grab your hand. Your hands is what's helping you twist as well. So just watching my hands is a very big component.
All right, Triple T, thank you guys for watching. Make sure to like, subscribe, and share, and hit the bell that you never miss a video that me, Riley, or Macy posts. So Riley's video should be coming up soon. I'm not sure about their posting schedule, but I just wanted guys to get this out so that you guys have a basis of what our channel is about. And if you guys are still having trouble with the cartwheel, then I suggest you just keep practicing those steps over and over again, because practicing makes better. Practice doesn't make perfect. Practice makes better. So when you do something over and over again, it's your body trains itself to do it. You will just muscle memory to it. So if you guys are having still a problem, then just do it. It's, you just got to keep doing those steps over and over again. That's how I learned how to do a cartwheel. I mean, I kind of learned it right off the bat, just like watching somebody. But some people who are more visual and who have more problems doing cartwheels, just do those steps over and over again. And if you guys are still not having trouble, then maybe you guys should watch somebody else's video who may be more professional. Because I'm not a professional. As you saw, I'm not a professional. Just hoping that this helps you guys out at least a little bit so that you guys can get the basis of a cartwheel. Or even if you guys are just trying to critique your cartwheel, then here's the place to be. So my name's Asia. Thank you guys for watching Triple T, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.